does not have the makhraj of the حروف الجوف. But يعني it's for you to know that حروف الجوف is الألف والواو والياء المادية. Then he says ثم لأقصى الحلق all the further همز هاء ومن وسطه أو من وسطه فعين حاء أو وثم ثم لأقصى الحلق همز هاء ثم لوسط لوسطه عين فعين حاء. يعني if you are going to read it you know like you know I told you that I read it تقول ثم لأقصى الحلق همز هاء ثم لوسطه سكون على السين يعني ثم لوسطه فعين حاء أدناه غين خاؤها. So that's مخارج of the جزاك الله خير ما شاء الله that's nice the interior or the chest area or chest area or the oral cavity you have the alif and the waw and the ya and they are in the bottom there you're right so when you say keep saying it I want you to say and feel it coming from closer to your chest you will see that the ringing sound after the cough that is the alif al mad you see it's coming and when you say li same thing but what is the difference here in the ya you find the tongue moved huh the tongue moved a little bit up li right but when you say qa there is clearance it's clear but when you say the ya the middle of the tongue came up okay then we say no more up in the back okay so the waw because of the dhamma that will come in the sifat by the way when we come to the sifat al-huruf you will see that more often so he mentioned the makharij al-makhraj al-halq makhraj al-halq halq lower throat it starts from under the tongue the root of the tongue and to you know the chest you know between the collar bones so this is the makhraj of the throat and it has six letters three pairs so one makhraj six letters three pairs and the makhraj has sub three sub makhraj so when we say makhraj al halq hada general how many letters in makhraj al halq six طب how many sections within مخرج الحلق three you know أقصى closer to the chest وسط أو وسط middle and أدنى أدنى يعني toward the tongue right أدنى الأرض في أدنى الأرض يعني the area close to you غلبت الروم في أدنى الأرض وهم من بعد غلبهم سيغلبون أقصى المسجد الأقصى you see the other side الأقصى الأدنى this side so when you say الأدنى يعني someone closer to you الأدنى also means someone below you that's why the word دنيا comes دنيا والعليا right so يعني أدنى الحلق so he said أقصى الحلق there is همز وهاء ووسط الحلق there is the عين and the حاء without the dots. We mentioned that in التحفه remember we mentioned that in التحفه في احكام الاظهار if you remember يعني okay when we said للنون اربع احكام فخذ تبييني فالاول الاظهار قبل احرفي للحلق remember that he's not talking about مخارج في التحفه but he's saying the اظهار of the نون will be when it is followed by one of the letters of الحلق يعني سد فالأول الإظهار قبل الحروف للحلق ست رتبت فلتعرف رتبها يعني مرتبة همز فهاء ثم عين حاء مهملتان remember the word مهملتان means they don't have dots so that's what he means what he says here he says ثم لوسطه فعين حاء So I'm telling you, عَيْنٌ حَاءٌ مُهْمَلَتَانِ. أَدْنَاهُ غَيْنٌ خَاءُهَا. أَدْنَاهُ غَيْنٌ خَاءُهَا. يعني عند أدنى الحلق there is غين وخاء. Why is it خاءها؟ يعني عشان الوزن. Because of the وزن, you know, because of the balance of that bone. So أدناه غين خاؤها. Until خاؤها here, مخارج الإيه؟ الحلق انتهت. That's why I'm telling you there is a line of the poetry, regardless how the meaning is connected, and there is the end of the sentence, grammatical sentence. So here he's talking about مخارج الحلق. So he says from line 11, ثم then لأقصى الحلق همز هاء ثم لوسطه فعين حاء أدناه غين خاؤها. That's it. Then القاف هذه أقصى اللسان. يعني next مخرج. So when you memorize a poem, there is one thing. You memorize it for the rhyme, for the rhythm, for the memorization, for all of that. That's okay. But when you come to the explanation, you have to know where it stops and where it picks up. So knowing the meaning actually helps you to memorize. Yes? Knowing the meaning helps you to memorize. I told you before, if you remember, you connect one line with the next line while you are memorizing. يعني when you're memorizing, you're going to say ثم لأقصى الحلق همز هاء ثم لأقصى الحلق همز هاء ثم لأقصى الحلق همز هاء to memorize that section, right? Then you are going to say ثم لأقصى الحلق همز هاء ثم لأقصى الحلق همز هاء ثم. Just connected the next word in the next line. That way, when you are saying the first half, you remember the beginning of the second half. Huh? Then you're gonna separate and say ثم لوسط لوسطه فعين حاء ثم لوسطه فعين حاء ثم لوسطه فعين حاء, like that. All right. Then you say the whole line together. You say ثم لأقصى الحلق همز هاء ثم لوسطه فعين حاء أدناه. You get the next word, you know, and you keep going like that. Then the poem becomes easy in your head to remember, inshallah. But when you know where the sentence ends, it gives you a mental image, yeah, of the meanings. So you kind of understand, inshallah. And you can quote also. This helps you quote the poem whenever you want to quote it. Then you know where to start and where to stop. فمخرج, the مخرج, أقصى الحلق همز وهاء. طيب, how you memorize, how do you know, how do you kind of figure out the مخرج or feel it or practice it? Put, that's what they say, put a همزة with a كسرة. The فتحة or a كسرة or ضمة doesn't matter, but كسرة makes it clearer. Put a همزة with a كسرة before the letter that you want to feel or know the مخرج of, and then put سكون on that letter. Okay? So you put a kasra before and the sukun in the letter. So put a sukun in any letter. In this case, ha, for example, is a ha sukun. Now we put a hamza before it with kasra. So we're going to say eh, 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 right? Now where it ends is the makhraj. I want you to imagine as if you have eyes inside of your, you know, area of makhraj here. So we're going to say eh, feel it, eh. You know, that is the makhraj of the ha, which is very close to the chest and the end of the bottom of the throat. Hamza, eh, 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 eh. So they are there. So they are in the same line. As I told you before, this makhraj is an approximation of knowing because we are dealing with millimeters here, with areas with millimeters. So it is very hard to say, oh, the hamza is in the right side and the ha in the left side, or the hamza is a little bit above and the ha. Yeah, don't go there, you know. Some people, I actually, they studied with me and they were going that far, right? You know, Sheikh, is the hamza above the ha or below the ha? Is the hamza parallel to the ha? Ya akhi, ittaqillah. Yani, just move. It is down here, whereby, which millimeter and the right or the left or the parallel one up and down. This is not the issue for us now. Then you say إِه وإِه. هذا مخرج اسمه أقصى الحلق. So you can quiz your students by saying what comes from أقصى الحلق, or where the Hamza comes from, or how do you know that the مخرج is, you know, different ways for exercising and for emphasizing on the مخرج. So you need to Ask yourself that or ask your students that, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. What is the makhraj of the qaf? What is the makhraj of the ha? How do you emphasize the makhraj? Show me how do you know the makhraj? Huh? What is the makhraj? What is aqsa al-halq? What are in the aqsa al-halq? What are the six letters of halq? Subhanallah. Everyone, you can do 4 or 5 questions. And that's how actually, especially children or beginners, they learn very fast when you associate it like this.